Hey everyone, this is Kamran and today we're going to talk about the TCP/IP model. TCP/IP model was proposed to standardize the communication between the devices over a network. If you have watched our last video on the OSI model, you will know that we said the same thing about the OSI model. How is the OSI model different from the TCP/IP model then? The difference is that OSI model was a theoretical model and it did not have any practical implementations. While TCP/IP model is more practical, and this is the one that is used these days. And also the OSI model has 7 layers, while the TCP/IP model has just 4 layers. There is no one-to-one mapping between the OSI model layers and the TCP/IP model, but if you look at it, the application, presentation, and the session layers have been replaced with the application layer. Transport layer is still the same. Network layer has been replaced with the internet layer. And the data link and the physical layers have been replaced with the network access layer. At each of the layers of the TCP/IP model, we have a certain set of protocols which are used to help with the communication over the network. So first of all, at the application layer, we have HTTP, HTTPS, FTP, and so on. At the transport layer, we have the TCP and the UDP. We're not going to go into the detail of the TCP and UDP in this video, but in our next video, we'll be covering the transport protocols in much more depth, and we'll discuss the differences between the TCP and UDP, and when should we use which one of these. Next comes the internet layer, where we have IP, ARP, RARP, and so on. IP or the internet protocol is the most common one that you might be aware of, but we'll be discussing the other ones as we need them in the future videos. And the next one we have is the network access layer, which includes all the hardware, such as the routers, switches, and so on. Alright, so now that we know about all the layers of the TCP/IP model and the protocols which operate at each of the layer, let's take an example to understand how the TCP/IP model works. Let's say that we have an application which is using a network. Let's say that we have a browser and we are trying to open a website. The first layer that the browser will interact with is the application layer. The protocol which will be used at this layer in this specific case would be the HTTP protocol. The application layer would be responsible for things like getting the data from the application and preparing it in the format that is going to be transferred over the network, and also when the data is received, preparing it in the format that is going to be used by the application. And also to each different application on our computer will have a specific port assigned. This port is used to route the data to the application that needs the data. So for example, if we have 20 applications using the network, each of the application will have a different port number assigned to it. And this port will then be used to route the data coming over the network to that specific application. Then comes the transport layer. At the transport layer, we will have either TCP or the UDP. The responsibility of the transport layer is to divide the one piece of data that we receive into smaller chunks called the packets. And to each packet, it will also assign a header, which will include the meta information about the packet itself. And this meta information will be used on the receiver's end to arrange the packets and to prepare the single form of data. Next comes the internet layer. The protocol which will operate at the internet layer is the IP. At this layer, to each packet of data, it will assign the source and the destination IP addresses. And then comes the network access layer, which will take all the packets and it will assign the MAC address of the receiver and the sender to each packet, which will be used to identify the device which needs to receive the data. And also it will be responsible for converting the packets into the series of ones and zeros, which will be transmitted over the network. And that's it for the TCP/IP model. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below, and I will see you in the next one.